Right, in this video I'd like to talk about the distance formula. So let's suppose we have two generic points out here in the xy plane. This one down here being x1 comma 1. Those are x1s, they're subscripts. They're just to denote that x1 is different from x2. Right? They're not x squared, they're not exponents, right? They're called subscripts. So this point right here is x1 comma y1 for their corresponding x and y value. And this point up here is x2 comma y2 for just another generic point that's different from the first one. That's all. Right? So suppose we have two generic points out there in the xy plane. Our goal is to figure out the distance between them. How long is that? Is it 3 inches, 15 miles, you know, whatever. What's the length between those two points? All right, so what we're going to do is set up this little right triangle, right? Because we can, if we set up this right triangle, make this a 90 degree right here, then we can figure out the distance of this leg right here and the distance of this leg right here. Well, think about it. If this spot right here is x1 and this spot over here is x2, then the distance between x1 and x2 has to be x2 minus x1. It's like having, if this was 10 and this was 3, then the difference between them would be 7. 10 minus 3 would be 7. Right, so it's the same idea. X2 minus X1 would be that length. And same logic up here. Y2 minus Y1 would be that length. And so we would label our sides to be as such. X2 minus X1, Y2 minus Y1, and D. So those are expressions for the three sides of our right triangle. And since it is a right triangle, we can use the Pythagorean theorem to have a relationship between all three sides. And that would be leg squared plus the other leg squared is equal to the hypotenuse squared. Right, I just wrote it the other way where I put the hypotenuse squared on the left side instead of the right. But it's still the Pythagorean theorem. Leg squared plus leg squared equals hypotenuse squared, right? All right, well now that's what D squared represents. So if D squared is equal to this, then D has to equal the square root of all of that. And that is the distance formula, right? Distance D between two points, x1, y1, and x2, y2, is the square root of x2 minus x1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. Right? That will give you the distance. And we just derived the formula using the Pythagorean theorem and some knowledge about the distances between numbers. Right? So the distance formula will help you figure out the distance between two points. Right? So let's look at an example. All right, find the distance between negative 2, 1, and 3, negative 5. So, while you're practicing this at the beginning, it's probably not a bad idea to actually write out the formula. x2 minus x1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. So until you remember it, it's probably a good idea just to keep writing it down every time you're going to use it. And then at some point you will remember it and you'll just know what the formula is and be able to apply it. All right, so this is the distance formula. Now, we've got two points up here. Now, the question that usually comes up is, well, which point is x1, y1, and which point is x2, y2? Well, the good news, it does not matter. Right? Just pick one. Make one of them be x1, y1, and one of them be x2, y2. It doesn't really matter. All this thing down here is really saying is subtract the x values and square it, subtract the y values and square it, and then add those two things together, and then take the square root. That's really all this formula is saying. So don't get hung up on the what's x1, y1, what's x2, y2 situation. Just subtract the x values. So we'll go negative 2 minus 3. Negative 2 minus 3, right, for the x2 minus x1, plus, now subtract the y values. Since we went negative 2 minus 3, I would encourage you to go in the same order, same direction, so we'll go 1 minus a negative 5. So 1 minus a negative 5 squared, all right, and then just do the arithmetic. So we have the square root, see negative 2 minus 3 is negative 5 squared, yes, you do need those parentheses. Plus, this goes to, what is that, 1 plus 5? This goes to 1 plus 5. So this goes to 6 squared. Everybody see that? 6 squared. And so then that goes to the square root of 25 plus 36. No, you do not get the square root of 25 is 5, and the square root of 36 is 6, and this adds up to 11. It's not that simple because of the plus sign in there. So be careful, don't make that mistake. You have to follow the order of operations. We need to simplify underneath the square root symbol first before we actually take the square root of it. So then this ends up being the square root of 61. And of course, you can approximate that out to a decimal number, 7.81. Right, so that's the distance between those two points. Square root of 61 is the exact value, and 7.81 is an approximation. So, almost 8 units, whatever those units may be. And again, it doesn't matter which one was x1, y1, which one was x2, y2, because you just end up subtracting the x values and then getting a number and then squaring that. Subtract the y values, get that number, and then square that. Think of it this way. We went negative 2 minus 3, right? Negative 2 minus 3, and got negative 5, and then we squared that. Well, if we would have gone the other way, if we would have gone 3 minus negative 2, that would have been 3 plus 2, which is 5, and we still would have gotten 5 squared, which is 25. And this one over here would have been negative 5 minus 1, which is negative 6. Negative 6 squared, which is 36. We still would have gotten down to this line right here, the square root of 25 plus 36, which would then have taken us down to the square root of 61, or 7.81. So again, don't get hung up on what's x1, y1, what's x2, y2. Just understand that the formula says take the x values, subtract them, and square it. Take the y values, subtract them, and square it. Add those two numbers together, and then take the square root. That's really all the distance formula is saying we need to do. All right, so now that's the idea of the distance formula. Whenever you need to find the distance between two ordered pairs, the distance formula is a good one to use to help you figure that out. So now you'll go apply that to other problems. All right, study well. Please let me know if you have any questions.